Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Today we'll be discussing about manual correlation. So before we discuss about manual correlation, we'll get back to this web underscore reg underscore find, because this manual correlation and whatever we have discussed as part of web underscore reg underscore find, that we have discussed about the verification concept. Okay, so both are more or less same. Okay, now let me, because again, let me try to give the idea on this web underscore reg underscore find over here, so that you can recollect. First of all, you can reconnect. I mean, you can understand this web underscore reg underscore find. Based on that, we will try to understand the correlation. Okay. If you remember, the concept was, the main underlying concept was, user sends the request. Say user sends the first request over here. Say user sends the first request. Okay. Say server is sending the response one, and as per yesterday's class, we understood that server will also give some ID. Let me say SID. The ID is whatever it is giving server, say it is SID. One minute. Okay. So say client is sending this request. Okay. And the server has responded with this response here. So for this request, server is responding with this. That is what we understood. And if you remember, as part of web underscore reg underscore find, okay, if you remember, we understood that here say we are requesting for the login page. Okay, we are requesting for the login page. So it is going to give some content on the login page. Did you all remember? I know we took some reference over here. Excuse me. If you remember, I know for this response, in the response we are expecting some text. If the text is presented in the response, we are going to conclude that yes, we are getting the required page. In that case, we were passing our transaction. Otherwise, we were failing the transaction. Did you all remember that particular concept? And this is how we have performed. First of all, we copy the request from the script, and we go to the generation log, and we find the this one request line where we have noted down the some transaction number, and based on that we find the response, which is nothing but say we send this request and we got this request. Sorry, we send this request and we got this response. So first of all, from this response, we are trying to find the for this request, we are trying to find the response. In that response, we are trying to see some text previously. If you remember, I think previously we were using some what is that? Welcome to EBA. What was that? The message? Some EBA signing, something we have discussed, right? If you remember, So this response, as part of response, the text is getting up. Okay, earlier, as part of the response, we were getting the text. Okay, now I'm adding one more point saying that not only text, it is also gives some session ID over here. Okay, now here, first step is as part of manual correlation, first scan the script manually. I mean, observe the script manually. Okay, first of all, observe the script manually. Once you observe the script manually, find the dynamic data. Okay, just find the dynamic data, and then copy the dynamic data. Now see here, copy the dynamic data and find the request. Basically this dynamic data you will be find as part of the request data. Okay, so you will observe the script manually and find the dynamic data, and then find its respective request. Okay, let me divide this step. I think this can be one step. What happened? Hello, can you see my screen now? Can you see my screen? Fine. Okay, fine. It seems now at this particular time, it seems my internet provider is giving kind of restarting the server. You know, I'm just observing from last 3 or 4 days. Correctly at this particular time around 11:30 a.m. EST, my internet service provider, it seems they are restarting the things, so I had to re-log into my internet provider network. Fine. So here, first observe the script manually and find the dynamic value, and then find its respective request. Right? Say here, if you remember, yesterday we have recorded one script. Now let me open that particular script. Let me record that particular script today. Let me take a new script here. So I'm taking a web HTTP HTML. Let me say web tools. Otherwise web tools. correlation recording. And see here, you know, before we record, basically we have to make sure that we have to open application samples. Yep. And first of all, you have to start the web server. So start the web server means just you need to click, that's it. So the command prompt will open. We don't need to close that. And then samples, web, and here HTTP web tools application. Okay, Now here, as I said in the asterisk class, you have to make sure this star checkbox is selected. Now go here. Now click on record. Okay. Now let me select this particular URL over here. Now everyone over here, I'm going to recording options. I'm clicking on the recording options over here. Now see, I'm selecting HTML based script. Okay. Basically, we have been using URL based script. And yesterday the script was working fine, but it could not able to, it did not fail. Okay, as I said, you know, it is going to load all the source content, all the all the content. It is going to record all the request of all the content on the application. So that's where yesterday when we were you know, recorded the script, when we were replayed. It was showing all the pages. It was showing the bad page. At the same time, it was showing the good page. If you remember, as part of runtime viewer, it was showing all those things. So, I just suspect you know, this 11.5 trial version it has some issues. Okay. Now I'm just selecting HTML mode recording. Now see here, let me select username, start recording. Basically, I'm taking a new script instead of yesterday's script. I'm saying entering credentials. Jojo Bean, and here I'm including a transaction TS01 underscore 01 login. Okay, once this number stabilizes, let's see, I'm just sending, I'm saying ending the transaction. Now here, let me go to user underscore end. Okay, I'm simply logging out over here. Okay, let me include a transaction TS 01 underscore 02 sign off. Now let me click on sign off. Now let me end the transaction. Now let me stop the recording. Now see here. Now what I'm saying here I'm asking you to know, search this script here. I mean, just observe this script manually here. Just start know, looking at the script, and let me keep this outside of this transaction. Okay, here what I'm saying here, just start manually looking at the script. Okay, however, you know, we already know, know this is a dynamic value. And as I said here, a user session is a kind of a value, and this value seems to be a chunk, kind of a dynamic value. Okay, like this, just observe the entire script. Okay, basically once you start practicing, and I know sometimes based on the application type also, these values will vary. I will let you know there will be something called correlation rules. We'll be discussing that. So now here, say here we know this is a dynamic value. So that is what this first point is talking about. Okay, observe the script manually. Okay, find the dynamic data and then find its respective request. In the sense here, okay, here I observe this particular issue over here, and finding its respective request means, if you remember, as part of web underscore reg underscore find, as part of verification topic, we understood that, you know, we will take this particular request, right? Now I'm saying just make a note of this particular request over here. That is what this first step is talking about. Okay, find its respective request. Okay, then copy the request you know what you can do here, copy the dynamic data. The other way what you can do here, copy this dynamic data over here, go to this output, go to this code generation, okay. Now see here, Control F, I think this is the value that we are trying to search. Yes. Now say, let me say find next. Can you all agree here, somewhere we got this one. Everyone agree here? Here we got this. Now from here slowly go up and see which should be a response over here. Can you all agree here? What actually here I'm trying to explain here, I think I'm making you a bit confused. 1 minute. Okay, let me come step by step. Here I know we are sending a request, and for this request, server is giving. Even over here, I'm just explaining from the starting point onwards again. I'm combining three topics. Like I'm showing practically, and I'm explaining the steps. I'm explaining this figure. First of all, we will complete this figure. Okay. Then we'll observe the practically, and then we'll write down the steps over here. Okay, we'll go one by one. So here, what I'm saying here, we send the request, and here server is going to give the response plus some session ID here. And here, in the request to what we have to do here, in the request to, we have to use the session ID plus request to. Then we will be sending we'll be sending this one. That is what yesterday we understood, right? First, whenever we connect to the server, it is going to give some ID over here, some value here, and based on that value, we will be using that value for further communication. So here in the request to, I will be sending this session ID, and then this request to, and the server again it may give a new session ID, or may have a same session ID. It may give something here. It will give response to, or it may also give some session ID to also maybe. Okay. I cannot give guarantee, but sometimes there will be some applications like this. But however, here first of all try to understand the concept. I send the request, server has given response plus session ID, and for further communication I am using the request plus session ID over here. Okay, now if you see here, now you are able to see this particular request. Now anyone can you guess, now as part of this example, now here we are able to see this particular dynamic data here, right? This is a session ID here, as in this is a SID here. Now, as part of this example, as part of this figure, now, is it a request 1 or request 2? I mean, say this is a session ID, okay? And here, this is a request of this particular session ID, okay? This is a session ID, and its actual request is this one. Now, this is a request. Is it a request 1 or request 2 as per this particular diagram? Are you getting my question? Is it request 1 or request 2? If you are able to think and if you are able to guess this one, you are done. Is it request 1 or request 2? Any guesses? First of all, did you get my question? Try to understand here. Here I said one figure. First of all, did you understand this particular figure here? Is there any question on this particular figure over here from anyone? First of all, let's go step by step. Yep. Is there any questions over here on this particular highlighted figure from anyone? Please respond. This is a very important topic, and it is very simple. If you understand the trick, you are done. Okay. If you understand the trick, you are done. Basically, it is a very complicated topic, but there is a small trick. Any questions on this from anyone? Okay, great. I don't see any question from anyone. That is great. Okay. Now here, I'm saying that here we are able to see this particular dynamic data. We are able to see this particular dynamic data as part of this request over here. Okay. Now just consider here, forget about this complete script over here, just as per our example here, now what we can say here, this particular request, now can I call this, say, can I call this particular request, as request 1 or request 2? That is my question here. Is this request, is the above request request 1 or request 2? Any guesses? This is my question here. Yep, that's correct, Devin. And any guesses from others? Is it request 1 or request 2? Fine. Let me go back here. This is a request which is having some session ID, right? This is a request which is having session ID. Now let me update this one. This is a request which is having session ID, right? Which is having some session ID over here. Now can you close the observer here? Can you all close the observer here? Everyone please try to understand this. Okay. This is a request which is having a session ID. Now can you guess, is it a request 1 or request 2? As part of this example, what we can conclude on this particular one? Is it a request 1 or request 2? No, okay, it's okay. Now see here we have a request 1. Which, does it have any session ID over here? Can you all see here? This is a request 1. Does it have any session ID over here? And it is a request with certain session ID over here. Can you all observe? This is some request which is having some session ID. Now here also we have some request which is having some session ID, right? Can you all observe this? Now here we have a request with some session ID over here. This request is having some session ID. Now as per this example, now is it request 1 or request 2 now? It's a request 2, right? This one is a request 2. I mean, wherever you find the dynamic data, that particular request is nothing but you can understand it is a request 2. Okay, you know, forget about the number of requests that is showing in your script. You know, just understand this particular concept. First of all, try to understand the concept. Here, of course, when you look at this particular script, you can see so many requests and all. Forget about all those things. I'm saying here, wherever you see, just remember this particular figure. Okay, just remember this particular figure and this concept. You can write any correlation. Okay, just remember this particular figure and the concept. Here, we have request plus session ID over here. Okay, it means this is resemblance this. From where we are getting this session ID? Here in this particular highlighted one, in this particular highlighted cell, from where we are getting this session ID? Can you technically speak out? I mean, can you technically type here in the chat box? From where we are getting the session ID over here? Can you all technically speak? I mean, can you all technically can you type in the chat box? Can you post your guess in the chat box? Yep, Sridhar, you are almost there. Yep, fine. Of course, everyone has, that's correct. I'm asking from where you are getting the session ID. In this request 2 plus session ID, from where we are getting this session ID over here? Yep. Here we are getting the session ID from the response of the first request. Right? Can you all observe this? I hope everyone is following what I'm trying to say here. This session ID we are getting from the response of the request 1. Right? Request 1 over here. Okay? This is the session ID that we are getting from the request of the other response, response of other request. Okay, so this session ID is coming from the response of this one. Okay, now this response is nothing but it, which is a part of this request. Okay, and if you want to find some information, if you remember web_reg_find, where we have used that web_reg_find? Above to the request, go to the request, we'll be using this web_reg_find so that it is going to capture the required information. Did you all remember that particular concept, web_reg_find? We will be using this web_reg_find before the request, okay, where we are going to get the expected value, expected text, okay. I mean, say here we have a request, say it is saying some, say it is requesting for login, okay, say login page request, say we have a login page request. So when we request for login page, basically we are getting a login page saying username, some password. So what we were doing, if you remember, we used some web_reg_find, and we were saying that, say I want to know this username, wherever, you know, I can see this username. We had some count, if you remember, we had some variable called save count, okay, and we ever mentioned some variable here. Did you all remember this one? I'm just, you know, switching now to the web_reg_find. Now also it is a similar concept, but here one level, that's a simple bit change here, okay. Now here, this we understood that web_reg_find. So where we'll be trying to find username, okay, which is a part of the response of this particular request. Now here, what we have to do here, if you want to use this session ID, if you want to know this session ID, which will be a dynamic session ID over here. Once this session ID is been captured, it is basically from the next session onwards, it is going to be dynamic. That is what we have understood in yesterday's session. Currently, this session ID is being hard-coded over here. Okay, this session ID is simply hard-coded over here. Now we have to remove this hard-coded value, and for the next time, whenever we are trying to replay, the server is going to give a new session ID. That session ID, server is going to give a new session ID, which will be part of one of the request. Okay, so in this case, we understood that the server is going to give this session ID as part of this request one over here. Now if you want to capture this session ID here, before this request, we have to keep something called web_reg_save_param, okay, which is a value which will help you to capture a set of value. Here basically the web_reg_find is basically, it will simply validate whether expected text is presented or not. But here we have something called web_reg_save_param, which is an API call, which is a web protocol API call, which will help you to extract the dynamic value. Where we have to extract? Before this request one, we have to keep something called web_reg_save_param. Why not on before request 2? Why we should not keep before request_2? Why we should not keep under, I'm saying there is a, say, just observe that function, web_reg_save_param. Say this is some function. We'll discuss more about this function. I'm saying that we have to keep this function before this request one. Why we should not keep this function here before this request 2? Why we should not keep over here? Are you getting what I'm saying, what I'm asking? Because we should not keep here, because here server is not giving as part of this request. Server is giving the session ID as part of this request. Okay. Server is giving the this session ID as part of this request. That is the reason we are mentioning something called some function before this particular request. So that this function will do, it will extract the current dynamic value from the server response. Okay, say you are requesting for login page here. So as we discussed, when you request for something, server will give some session ID. So before that request, we'll keep something. So whenever server is giving some information, from that server information, we'll extract the dynamic value. Okay, by using this function, we'll extract the dynamic value, and we'll extract that value into a variable here. Okay, so, and once we extract that variable, whatever the variable that is being mentioned in this particular function, which will be dynamically used over here, which will be used over here. Okay, now in this case, now here, everyone observe here. Now this is a session ID that we have understood here, that we have captured here, and obviously this session ID is a part of one of the response here. Okay, that responses should be, that response should be before the request of this particular request. Try to understand, this is one of the requests. So here this session ID is part of one of the response. Now this is a request. This is a request. And this is a one of the output of one of the requests over here. This is a it is a part of one of the response of the previous before request over here. So now here, what we are trying to do here, we just copied this. Now go here in the generation log, control F, I'm finding next. Now if you all observe here, this should be part of the one of the response. Now see, this dynamic value is a part of the one of the response here. Why it is part of the response? That is what we have been understanding. Okay, we will be getting the dynamic value from the server. So now this is the value which is being given by the server here. Now how can we know for which request we are getting this particular response? Okay, how can we know for which request we are getting this particular response? Can anyone answer? Because we already discussed this particular part. How can I find for which request we are getting this response? We have discussed, we already discussed as part of web underscore reg underscore find for verification. Now simply here just move up. See here, we are moving up and find the transaction ID here. Everyone observe here. Can you all observe here? Here we can find some transaction ID here. And if you observe here, now how I'm concluding this as a response? Now can you all observe here? It is showing some response body over here. Okay. It is showing as a response body here. And I'm just capturing this transaction ID here. Okay. Now let me go to the top. Now let me search for the with this particular transaction ID. Now we actually need the request of it. Why we need to find the request of that particular response? Because before that request only we have to keep this function. Whatever the function that we are trying to understand, we have to keep that function before that request only here. Now see here, can you all observe here? Now I find the request of this particular transaction. Now scroll down. I'm just trying to see this request. Yep, I guess no, this one. So here, let me copy this one. Now if we go here in this particular where we have this index.html. Somewhere we should find it, right? 1 minute. Actually, no, here I know that directly here I know that this is the request. Why it is not showing here? 1 minute. And why it is showing ID? Request header, response header. One on it. Actually, I'm trying to see this web underscore that particular retriever. Why it is capture all this amount? Mm-hmm. 1 minute. How many requests we have here? Okay, fine. See here. However, see here, this is the session ID. So here, what we can do here. This is a session ID which has been getting as part of the basically the response of this particular request. I mean wherever we can see this dynamic data, just ignore that. Okay, just to go to the previous one of it. Okay, wherever you find the dynamic data, ignore that particular request. Go to the above request, because whatever we see the dynamic data, which should be obviously part of the response of the other request. That's the reason, go to the previous request and then try to capture that value over here. So here I'm trying to find this particular response over here. Request header and response ID. Now here, 1 minute. Let me copy this dummy value. Let me see if it have miss. But I don't think so. It is having miss. I don't see the request of this. What is happening? Fine, it's okay. So the simple thing is, now the other way is what you can do here. Now wherever you find this dynamic data, okay, ignore. Just it's a simple step. Wherever you find the dynamic data, just ignore that particular step. Ignore that particular request here. Okay, go to the request of the above step. Go to the previous request here, okay, and here try to use this something called reg underscore save underscore param, okay, and it should be small. Okay, now here let me show the set of parameters. It is going to have some set of parameters over here. Based on your requirement you will be using. Here we need to understand one example here. Say for example, here just 1 minute. Now see here, now this is a kind of a dynamic data. I mean, say for the first time, say server is giving this information. Second time, server is giving this information. Third time, server is giving this. Fourth time, it is giving like this. Now, when you see these four things, which is a constant at the left side? What is the value which is constant at the left side? And when you observe these four values, what is the constant value on the left side? Okay, and what is the constant value on the right side? Yep, it's very simple. So it means whatever the value which is between, now whatever the value which is in between this less than ABCD and this JHIJKL then is called as dynamic value, right? I can say this one, right? I can say this statement. I mean, what are the value which is in between less than symbol and this, I mean less than left value and this right value, that value will be called as a dynamic value here. Do you agree with me over here? So here, basically that value is nothing but that we have to capture here. Whatever the value which is in between these two values, we need to capture. Now here, basically why we are going to this response and why we are trying to find the request and all. Basically here in the response, here we were trying to find the particular response, right? Now here, say even when you execute for if you record for one more time or if you record for three more times, what will happen here? This value, this value, this left side value will be common. Okay, you record for 100 times, for 100 times this left value will be same, and probably this value will vary. Okay, and obviously at the end it is going to have a right greater than symbol. So technically it will be called as a left boundary here. So we'll be mentioning there something called left boundary. Left boundary means this less than symbol ABCD. So it means we are giving what is the boundary of the left side, what in your request what it is going to contain. I'm giving some instructions that less than ABCD here, and we'll be having something called right boundary here. Okay, and here we will be mentioning like this. I mean, in this case, in this elbow example, we'll be mentioning I, J, K, L, and we'll be mentioning like this. Okay, currently in this particular example, in this current example, the left boundary will be this. You can give this value or you can give this value. It's okay, you can take the part of it. Okay, say I'm taking this particular value, user session value equal to. Okay, now in this currently in our example here, this left boundary will be like this. This is the left boundary. And what is the right boundary means? Simply this greater than symbol here. Okay. Now whatever the value in between this value and this right boundary, it is going to capture. It is going to capture. So it will capture. But it has to capture and it has to save in some parameter over here. Okay. It has to save in some parameter over here. Now here, you know, we have some set of options here. Okay. Say here, it is going to have some list of attributes. It is not opening. Yep. Now here, can you see here, the mainly here left boundary is important, okay? And here right boundary is important. I mean, you have to mention left boundary and right boundary. It might be any type, any parameters that you want to mention. You have to know what is the left boundary, what is the right boundary. I mean, in which values basically your dynamic value is getting up. Okay. So you have to find this left boundary value, right boundary value over here. Okay. After that, here, I will let you know the other parameters also. It is giving like this. I may not recommend this, at least this trial version, probably, you know. Okay, fine. Here, see here. Now here I'm mentioning this web underscore, reg underscore serve parameter. And here you can give the appropriate parameter name. Now let me say it's a user session correlation param 1. You can give any parameter name here. You can give any name. I am just giving some user session correlation param 1. You can give ABCD or whatever the parameter name you can give here. It means once it excites, this value will be captured into this variable over here. And here you can give left boundary. Okay. Here you can give the left boundary. Here you can agree. Here you have to give the left boundary like this and right boundary. Left boundary equal to, and what is the left boundary? This one. We assume that you can if you want, you can start from here. You can start from here, but it is try to be take part of it, and I will give some more information on this. As of now, I'm just showing this. Okay, now let me also give the right boundary over here. Now here right boundary will be this greater than symbol. Okay. And here should be like this. No, right boundary is actually. Okay, we'll see. So right boundary will be this. And say if you are done with these parameters, you can simply say last over here. Okay. Now here, let me compile here. Okay. Now simply have mentioned left boundary and right boundary, and it will capture that value, and that value will be captured into this variable. Okay. Now this value will be captured into the response of this particular request. Okay. This value will be captured basically as part of response of this particular request. And if you remember, this is a load runner related variable here. This is a load runner related variable. So, and if you want to use this load runner related variable here, now see here, I'm just copying this one. I'm just commented this. Now here I'm just removing this one. This is a load runner related variable. You can directly make use of this load runner variable in a load runner programming here. Say if you want to convert into some other things, then we have to use this lr underscore eval string, lr underscore save string and all. But here, if you want to use it, just use less than symbol, right symbol, and left this floor basis and parameter, and right parenthesis. Okay. Now here, say I'm just curious to know what is the value that has been captured over here. Okay. Now for that, let me do one thing. Everyone observe, I'm just curious to know what it has been captured. So that's the reason I'm saying lr eval string. Okay. Here I will be mentioning this particular parameter. And here lr underscore output underscore message. Okay. Now I'm just curious to know what is this value. Now I'll try to execute this one. Actually, it is very very simple, but the thing is, understanding is very important. Okay, the how we need to proceed is important. Now, can you all agree here in the application here? It is showing this particular page. Now it is logging out. Can you all observe this particular replay log? Here, let me click on back. And here, it is clearly explaining, we have a login page. And we have a sign-in page. And here, we have a log-off page. Okay? And moreover here, we have printed that value, right? Can you all observe this? Actually, no, this is the value which is printed as part of 24th line. You can see here. This is the 24th line. This is the value that has been captured during the execution runtime here. And see here, this is the value which has been captured during the runtime. And we'll see what is the value during the recording over here. I just commented this line. Can you all agree here? Can you see here? This value my probably is same. This value is same. But can you all agree that this value is different? Can you all see this? This is the value which we have captured. This is the highlighted value which we have captured during the execution. The other value which was during the recording. So if you would have executed with the recorded value, it would have failed here. If you really want to understand whether it is going to fail or not, what you can do here, let us just comment this. I'm just commenting the correlated parameter, and here let me comment all the correlated related logic over here. I'm just commenting all the correlated correlation related logic here. Okay, we'll save this, and now we'll try to execute this. Now I'm just executing this particular script without correlation related logic. Okay, I just commented the correlation related logic. We are trying to execute this one. It will execute. Yes, now it is executing. Now can you observe here in the you have reached the page incorrectly, and to be frank, you know, I'm not sure, actually it is expected to fail, but it is not failing. Okay, I'm not sure, you know, for those people, is there anyone who has the loader on 11? Basically it is expected to fail here. Okay, I know I'm just suspecting loader on 11.5, and moreover, probably, you know, I will share basic loadrunner videos. I have to find those videos, okay? In those videos, it was failed, okay? I'm suspecting this. It is expected to fail, fine. And however, you can see, you can just observe here the difference over here. However, it is giving the correct output over here. Yeah, reach the page incorrectly, okay? And however, if you go back to the script here, and now here again, let me enable this particular correlation related. Let me comment this one. And here, if you just wanted to, okay, I just enable the correlation related one. Now here, let me give let me explain this example one more time here. What we have done simply, first of all we find the dynamic value and we find its request, and we ignore that request, and we just go to the above of that particular request, and above to that request we have used something called web_reg_save param. Okay, so by using that function, basically we can capture a value. Okay, so here what value we need to capture, which value we need to capture, for that we have to know what is the left boundary and what.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2k